Hello, we're the Browns.
I'm Jean.
I'm John. We moved into Ulrus in 1967 onto the Walkfield estate, which was being built then. Moved in September. It was called Coppice Grange then, rather upmarket name. But all the locals used to know it as the Bullring because of all us 0121s from Birmingham, obviously.
I started work at Bisbal Magnets in Park Road in 1975. I went there for 6 weeks to help out and stayed there for 27 years. Michael Lloyd Morris was the owner of the company and he used to employ everybody from Ulrus. Michael was great friends with the farmer, Tom Mellor, who's the farmer's opposite us, and he used to lend us his tractor and trailer. But he always used to forget to sweep it down, so it did smell rather. But one year we won first prize and Eddie the Eagle was judging the competition and we had to go and meet him, which was great for all us lot. We also did the CB club in the village with a few helpers, and we used to run charity events. We did one a pram race for a little lad in the village who'd got MS and raised about £400, which in those days was quite a lot of money. The club was called the Village Broadbenders and everybody used to have a handle. Mine was China Doll, John's was Pied Piper, even the bar staff had a handle. Joan Green was P. Green, Roy Walker was Rusty Walker. And we used to have loads of fun events.
But in those days it was illegal, wasn't
yes.
it? Which made it rather popular. And even the local Bobby had got a handle. He won't admit it, but he used to come.
With his wife, Sue.
Good days, good days. And it was like a family event, really, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Kids and parents, a lot of fun, a lot of fun.
Yeah.
During the CB days, we used to hold all sorts of things, and football matches were a classic, which we had juniors, ladies and men's teams, and we had matches against Litchfield Three Spires Club, and on one occasion I dressed up as the nurse, wig, big pair of glasses, nurse's uniform that didn't fit very well, the lady I borrowed up was quite a slender person. Fishnet stockings and size 10 trainers, looked very elegant. But I was lucky really because nobody recognised me. But during that match, one little lad broke his collarbone. Unfortunately, the only bit of kit I'd got was a sling. So we managed to patch him up, but we did need a bit of medical assistance. So somehow he scraped through. Good days.
I used to help Ben, the local policeman, and his wife Sue with our local youth club, which we held in the village hall. Ben used to be upstairs doing all competitions with darts, snooker. He used to take the lads out and teach them to ride a motorbike. And us girls who were helping out, we used to help the girls with routines in the main hall, and we used to take them to dancing competitions all over Litchfield, Tamworth, everywhere, and they still talk about it when you meet them over the field today.
I have been here 47 years. During those years we brought up two lads, us being townies and the lads obviously village lads, and a wonderful life, really. Such a difference, the freedom that the kids get, and still now. And we have wonderful neighbours and a lot of friends in the village. And let's hope it continues.